This story is one of the adventures of Bones and his friend Dodo. Bones is a 3-year-old brontosaurus and is 5 feet long, the size of a small pony. Dodo is a baby pterodactyl and is about as big as a blackbird. In this tale, Bones and Dodo fight the mean 50-foot-long and 19-foot-high Tyrannosaurus Rex called Tyro. And they make friends with a Stegosaurus called Gus, who is 30 feet long. His back is covered with 2 rows of diamond-shaped plates. He eats every plant in sight. After a short song, our story will begin. When you hear this sound, turn the page.
Here's the kind of story I enjoy in every way. How it is that clever people somehow win the day. The world's full of dinosaurs, each one big or small. Some are very nice friends and others not at all. Learn to tell the difference, learn which way to go. Just like Bones and Dodo, there's a lot you should know. So listen to a story, cause it will help you learn and grow. Come on!
Bones and Dodo in The Creature in the Cave. Bones and Dodo had played all day in the forest. It was time to go home, but they didn't know which way home was.
You promised you knew the way,
moaned Bones, a 3-year-old brontosaurus. Dodo, his pterodactyl friend, was a flying dinosaur. Rumbles of thunder were rolling closer and closer. Lightning streaked across the sky and it began to rain.
Let's find a dry place, said Bones,
and the two boys hurried to a cave. The boys were glad to be inside. Bones was even happier when he saw a pile of cool green leaves.
I wonder how they got here, said Bones.
I brought them here,
growled a deep voice from the back of the dark cave. Coming toward them was a creature as big as an army tank, with giant pointed plates across his back.
Who are you?
Asked Bones, his voice shaking.
Call me Gus. Everyone does.
For a moment, we thought you were Tyro,
said Dodo, who, like all creatures in the land, was afraid of meeting the most dangerous dinosaur of all.
Yes, said Gus. He's one mean-eating machine. I've seen those jagged teeth and those tiny beady eyes.
You've met him?
Gasped Bones.
See this scar?
Gus boasted.
That's where Tyro tried to take a chunk out of me.
Bones and Dodo patted Gus on his back. It was hard as a rock. Outside the cave, the thunderstorm had stopped, and a full moon made night into day.
I'll walk you boys home,
offered Gus.
Your folks will be worried.
Bones and Dodo followed Gus down the path across the meadow and past the palm trees that led to Bones' home. And then a sudden crack shattered the air.
Not another thunderstorm,
groaned Bones. But it wasn't a thunderstorm. Standing before them, on 2 gigantic hind legs, was a monster the size of a 5-story building.
Tyro!
Tyro! The beast roared and lunged for Gus.
We better help Gus,
Bones said.
Dodo, fly around Tyro's head. That'll make him forget Gus.
Tyro snapped at Dodo with his knife-like teeth and grabbed for him with his claws. But Dodo was too quick. Bones remembered a cliff he'd seen nearby. And he figured out how to get Tyro to the edge of it. Bones gulped, took a deep breath and yelled,
Come and get me!
Tyro looked away from Dodo towards the sound of that voice. Tyro roared and chased Bones, knocking down the trees and bushes along the way. Bones ran and led the terrible monster right to the spot where the land ended. Bones jumped aside. Gus appeared from behind a tree, pushed the back of Tyro's legs, and the beast fell over the cliff and into a sticky tar pit.
Hooray for us,
said Bones.
You two are the bravest boys I've ever known,
said Gus.
I guess it doesn't matter how big you are. You're big on courage, and that's what counts.
Can we come visit you again?
Asked Bones.
Oh, sure,
said Gus.
I love getting company, and maybe I'll tell you about the time I won the Dinosaur Derby.
You won?
Dodo said.
But you're not very fast.
Well, that's what makes it a good story,
Gus answered.
But that, my friends, is for another time.
Now that's my kind of story, adventure. The way Hello to Gaza uses smarts always win the day. The world is full of creatures, not at all like you and me. Some are good and some are bad, as we can plainly see. But if we keep our courage, our hearts ahead, we'll see our way through space and come out ahead. And that's the way it ought to be in stories we have read.
If you'd like to hear this story again, after the next song, just turn over the tape. Remember, there are three more stories in this collection.